Okay, so in this video, we're going to be talking about accuracy and precision of a number. So this typically comes about when we're talking about different kinds of numbers and measurements. Either when it comes to engineering, honestly, when it comes to any kind of field where you have to measure things out where they need to be pretty precise. So, I mean, think about NASA and engineers and the mechanics. And everything involved in building those, you have to be very specific in your measurements and putting things together because sometimes the slightest little difference can throw everything else off. So it's important when it comes to numbers to know how precise is it, how accurate is that number. So that's what we're going to talk about today. So, first off, talking about accuracy and precision, they almost sound like they might mean the same thing, but I'm here to tell you they're not. So the difference between them. So when it comes to accuracy, right? Accuracy deals with the number of significant digits you have in a given number, right? So accuracy is the number of significant digits. So how many? So if I'm given a number that has five digits inside of it, right? How many of those are actually significant? Right, so that's what we're talking about when it comes to accuracy. So then we need to know, well, okay, what are significant digits? How do I know which ones are significant, which ones are not? And I have our rules here at the bottom of the screen to tell us. So the first thing says, digits other than zero are always significant. Right, so anything that's not a zero, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, those will always be significant. The only ones that might not be significant are zeros. Sometimes they will be, sometimes they won't. We need to figure out. So bullet point two will help us with part of that. So zero is significant when it appears between two significant digits. So if I have a zero between two significant digits, so for example, maybe the number 203, because of the fact that the zero is in between a two and a three, that means it's significant. Or even if I had like 21.5093, the fact that the zero is in between two significant digits, then that zero would be included. Okay, so our second bullet point says that a zero is significant when it is at the right end of a decimal number. So, in order to give us an idea of what that's talking about, I want to give you the number 15, and then I want to give you the number 15.0. Now, even though technically they have the same value, $15 is the same thing as $15, whether I have 15 and I'm telling you 15 and no change, right? It's exactly the same thing. But the difference of the 0.0 tells us this. So, let's pretend maybe this was 15 inches. All right, so I measured and it's about 15 inches. Now, the fact that I said that it's 15.0 inches means that that is very precise and it is accurate up into that tenths of a decimal place value. 15.0 is considered more accurate. It is more precise because of the fact that I've added in that 0.0 to it. So that's the difference. Even though they mean the same thing, adding the 0.0 to it means that it's more precise. And our third bullet point there says that a zero is significant when it is marked significant with an over bar. So for example, if I had the number 2700, right? So these zeros here, we haven't finished going through our rules yet, so we don't necessarily know if they're significant or not. But if I have an over bar on the number, it looks just like that, just like a line over it, almost like a repeating decimal. The fact that that has an over bar on it means that it definitely is significant. Anytime you see that over bar, it means you can include it in how many significant digits you have. Okay, then, so then when is a zero not significant? All right, so taking a look at our bullet three here, we have two different things that tell us when a zero is not significant. The first says a zero is not significant when it is at the right end of a whole number. Again, a whole number, there's no decimal, fraction, or anything attached to it. So a whole number, so for example, the number 900 is a whole number here. If I have zeros at the end of a whole number, they are not significant. So if I were asking you how many significant digits I had in the number 900, it would just be one, this nine right here. These zeros are not significant. And the last point says that a zero is not significant when it is at the left end of a number. Okay, so it just says the left end of a number. So maybe if I had a number like this, right? Or maybe, you know, if I had something like this, I mean, think about it. You know, if let's pretend this were money. If I had $12.30, it really would not make a difference if I put zeros in front of that number. It doesn't change the value or anything of it. So zeros in front are not significant. Okay, then. So now that we've kind of spoken about that, let's talk about the accuracy of the numbers that we have here. So I have numbers 1 through 8. So first, I want to give you about a minute. See if you can go through these and tell me how accurate they are. So remember, accuracy is just how many significant digits are there. So your answers would be something like 2, 3, 5, 0, you know, depending on whatever the number is. So take a moment and just tell me, or see if you can figure out the accuracy of these just for a minute. Okay, so taking a look at number one, 8.3 pounds, right? So, well, honestly, this one should hopefully be one of our easy examples here. We don't even have any zeros in this example, and anything other than a zero is significant. So I have one, two numbers here that are non-zeros. So my number of significant digits is a 2. So the accuracy is 2. Next example, looking at 960 feet. So I can say for sure that I have 2 that are not zeros, right? So I at least have 2 significant digits. I do have this 0 over here at a right end of a number. So let's see, does it say anything about that 0? And actually, if we look at bullet point 3A, it says a 0 is not significant when it is at the right end of a whole number. So for this one, we only have 2 significant digits. Next example is 3.50 inches. So once again, I see 2 numbers to start off with that are not zeros, so I can at least say that I have 2 significant digits. I need to take a look at my rules for zeros here. And my rules say, well, let's see, it says a 0 is significant when it is at the right end of a decimal number. So this is the right end of a decimal, so I can include that here. We have 3 significant digits in this example. Okay, next example, 8775 gallons. I don't see any zeros in there, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4 non-zero digits. That means I have 4 significant digits. Next example, 0.04 kilograms. All right, so I have 1 non-zero number. So looking at these zeros here, our rules say that a 0 is not significant when it is at the left end of a number. So these are at the left end of a number. That means they are not significant. So we have 1 significant digit in this example. Moving on, so 17 psi. So here we have 1, 2 non-zero digits, and that's all that we have here. So 2 significant digits for that example. Moving along, our next example says 4,000 square yards. So zeros at the right end of a whole number are not significant. So for this particular example, we would only have 1 significant digit. And our final example, 1.375 liters. I don't see any zeros in this example, and we have 4 digits that are non-zero, which means we have 4 significant digits. Now remember, the number of significant digits is the same thing as accuracy. So the accuracy of this number is 4. Okay, moving on to precision. So let's talk about precision for a minute here. So taking a look at precision, precision is a place value. So after we figured out how many significant digits we have in a number, well, it's precise to what? So the precision is the place value of the rightmost significant digit. Okay, so going back through some of these numbers, the 8.3, it had 2 significant digits, so the rightmost significant digit would be the 3. That is the 10th place, so this example is accurate to the tenths. That's what precision means, the place value of the rightmost significant digit. So that 960 feet, right? It only had two significant digits in it because that zero did not count. So our rightmost significant digit there was a six, and that is the tens place. So it is precise up to the tens. So then taking a look at the next number that we have there was 3.50 inches. That zero at the right end or decimal was significant. So we had three significant digits in this one. And the rightmost place value, that is actually the hundredths place. All right, so if you don't remember your place values for decimals, you may want to go back and review that. So this is precise to the hundredths. Then we had the 8,000. Then we had the 8,755 gallons, so every single one of those was significant. Our rightmost place value is the ones. So you can say ones, sometimes depending on what the measurement, the unit here is, sometimes they just say it's accurate or it's precise to the nearest gallon, right? The nearest whole number, the nearest ones, whatever it happens to be there. So accurate to the ones, or you can just say precise to the nearest gallon. The 0.04 only had one significant digit there, and that is the hundredths place. So that means this one here is precise to the nearest hundredths. And just kind of moving along here quickly, the 17 PSI. So there was two significant digits there, the 1 and the 7. So that's nearest, or that's precise to the nearest ones or to the nearest PSI. 4,000 square yards, so the rightmost significant digit, the only significant digit we had there was the 4, so that is accurate, or I'm sorry, that is precise to the nearest thousandths place. And the last one, the 1.375 liters, that 5 was the rightmost significant digit, and that is the thousandths place. Right, so that one there would be precise to the nearest thousandths. So this is what we're talking about when we're talking about accuracy and precision. Accuracy, how many significant digits are there? Precise, up to what place value? Well, whatever the rightmost significant digit is, whatever place value that is, that would be your precision.